Hello, everyone. I'm Caruana with Microsoft's Customer Advocacy Group, and I'm here to talk to you today about one of my favorite collaboration tools, Microsoft Lists. So let's hop in. Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Coffee in the Cloud. Today, I'm going to talk with you about Microsoft Lists. And you might wonder, why am I talking about that? Because when people are collaborating well in Microsoft 365, it really increases their satisfaction as of users. It makes your adoption journey much easier. And it gives people real-world experience about some of the powerful things that exist in Microsoft 365. Lists is a very practical way to evolve people from tracking things in Excel spreadsheets, which is awesome. But when you move that data into a list, you unlock a whole host of capabilities that they didn't have before. Collaboration and co-authoring, being able to create different views of the same information depending upon who's working on it, and so much more. I've been using Microsoft Lists for a very long time, and I've always found them to be a cornerstone of my event management and project management scenarios, and they are so much cooler today. So let me hop in and show you a little bit of the adoption resources that we have to help you drive lists usage within your environment. Let's take a look. This is the home experience of Microsoft Lists in my day-to-day work. And you can see right up here, I can create a new list, but I can also do that in Teams or directly in a SharePoint site. When I do that, I get a great experience of the different types of list templates that already exist. So this is a really fast way of getting the most out of Microsoft Lists. So whether you're tracking issues, helping people onboard, maybe you have assets you need to keep track of, right? It can give you a work progress tracker or even travel requests with an approval form. So for instance, if I want to go ahead and create that, I'm just able to click on that and it's going to show me a nice visual example of what a list could look like. You'll notice some of that great color coding that you can do and categories. This advanced formatting is now available right in the Lists product, which I'm a visual person. So these colors really help me. The list is created with all of that already created for you when you select to use this template. It doesn't include any data, so it's just going to allow you to have the structure in place for the lists that you need. I love these templates and the way that the team is constantly creating new ones. And you'll notice that your own organization can create templates. So you can work with the IT admins, tenant admins in your organization to have your templates also created in this experience. So make sure to go and check this out. This is the Microsoft Lists Adoption Hub on adoption@microsoft.com. You know, this is one of my favorite Microsoft sites because it gives you so much practical information about the service usage and driving adoption of these key capabilities. So I'm really excited to walk you through the resources that exist for the capabilities that are out there for Microsoft Lists. So if you'll find this page up under our products menu, so you can find it right here, Microsoft Lists, and this is where you end up, right? Right here at the top, we have our own adoption playbook that's specifically for Microsoft Lists that gives you all the information you need about how to drive adoption in your organization and a ton of additional resources. If you scroll down the page, you'll also see that we've organized resources by where you might be on your journey with Lists. So maybe you're getting started and you really want to dive into that playbook or see our quick start guide. You might be a little further along. People know about lists, but you want to drive more usage of them. And so you can use our communications templates for that. Or maybe you're really at the place where you're ready to start training. And you can do that. Now, I always found it best for me to drive adoption of something that I actually understood and used. And so that's where our on-demand virtual workshop comes into play. You can watch this on demand. Fantastic information, really gives you a great grounding in how to use lists. I'm also a fan of our Lists Adoption Playbook. It gives you some slides that you can use in your own environment. You can customize them any way you want, but you'll be able to download this PowerPoint deck, and it will take you through so much of the information that you will need and more links to the resources that I've been discussing so that you can drive your own Microsoft Lists campaign. Lastly, there are a ton of resources back there on that homepage. When you can click through to resources, boy, this is where you're really going to get a ton of great information. So of course, we have all of our blogs, many of them by our own Mark Cashman or Lincoln Tamaris, who leads the List product management team. Lots of great folks who understand and love lists and are sharing information with you. But then if you keep scrolling, you'll be able to understand the home of lists, what the new creation process looks like, seeing those lists in action, and so much more. Then we have a great resource library for you. And these resources are great if you're doing a ask you anything about Microsoft Lists, or maybe you're doing a champions call inside your organization. You can run these videos or take snippets of these podcasts and bring them into your own organization. We have the video library here, our podcasts, we have customer stories, and of course, more help and support for the use of Microsoft Lists. Microsoft Lists is one of those cornerstone capabilities of collaborating. It can really up-level your work with other people. As I said, I'm a big fan of using Lists for event management, for project management, and really it's about the tool that makes people comfortable. But I especially like it to track information like asset management and what have you. And the new templates that we have available in the Lists experience are a fantastic way to speed time to value with this amazing product. You can go in and start that list, create new, and now it will even include things like approval workflows, which we used to have to build by hand and now are built into the list experience. Check out the demos we have on Microsoft Lists right there on that adoption page, but think about how you can improve the core usage of Microsoft 365 in your organization, because it's foundational to being able to do things like roll out Copilot and use the new AI capabilities. We're excited to see what you do with Microsoft Lists. Leave us some comments. Let us know how it's going for you. And if you have any questions, come and join us in the community. And we'll be happy to answer all your questions about Microsoft Lists. That's all for today. Thanks so much. And I'll see you soon.